My father, ancient, hallowed, lonely, disappointed father, betrayed and rejected ruler of the universe, angry, wrinkled old majesty, I want to pray. I want to say Kaddish. My own Kaddish. There may be no one to say it after me. So little time, as you well know. Is my end a minute away? An hour? Is there even time to consider the question? I could be here while we are singing, that we may be stopped once for all, cut off in the act of praising you. But while I have breath, however brief, I will sing this final Kaddish for you, for me, for you all, these I love here in this sacred house. To pray, and time is short. Yit gadal ve yit kadash shemei rabba. Amen. Magnified. Sanctified. Be the great name. abounding peace descend on us. Amen. Great God, you who make peace in the high places, who command the morning since the day's begun and cause the dawn to know its place, surely you can cause and command a touch of order here below on this one day's speck. And let us say again, with amen on my lips, approach your presence, Father, not to fear, but with a certain respectfully fury. Do you see, do you recognize my voice? I am that part of man to suggest his immortality, and surely remember, Father, the part of Euphrosyne's death that insists on you, devise your voices, guesses, your grace, and always you heard my voice, and always you have answered me with a rainbow, a raven, a plague, something. But now I see nothing. The time you show to me is nothing, nothing at all. Are you listening, Father? You know who I am. Your image, that stubborn reflection of you, that man has shattered, extinguished, punished, and now he runs free, free to play with new found fire. Avid to death, vulnerable, complete and final death. Lord God of hosts, I call you to account. You let this happen, Lord of hosts. You, with your manner, with your pillar of fire, you ask for faith. Where is your own? Why have you taken away your rainbow, that pretty bow you tied around your finger to remind you never to forget your promise? Follow, I do set my bow in the cloud, and I will look upon it that I may remember my everlasting covenant, your covenant. You're bargain with men. Tin God, your bargain is tin. It crumples in my hand, and when it fades now, yours are mine. Thank you. forgive me. Father, I was mad with fever. Have I hurt you? Forgive me. I forgot you too are vulnerable. But yours was the first mistake, creating man in your own image. Tender, fallible. Dear God, how you must suffer. So far away, ruefully eyeing your two-footed handiwork, frail, foolish, mortal. My sorrowful father, if I could comfort you, hold you against me, rock you and rock you into sleep.
Thank you.
Rest, my father. Sleep. Dream. Let me invent your dream. Dream it with you as gently as I can. And perhaps in dreaming, I can help you recreate your image and love him again. Take you to your favorite star, the world most worthy in your creation, and hand in hand we'll watch in wonder the workings of perfectionists. Father, just you planned it. Every immortal clean, intact. Lambs frisk, wheat ripples, sunbeams dance. Something is wrong. The light flat, the air sterile. Do you know what is wrong? There is nothing to dream, nowhere to go, nothing to know. And these, the creatures of your kingdom, these smiling, serene, and playless people, are they too created in your image? You are serenity, but rage as well. I know, I have borne it. You are hope, but also regret. I know, you have regretted me, but not these, not the perfectness ones. They are beyond regret or hope. They do not exist, Father, not even in the light year of the dream. Now let me show you. Dream to remember. Come back with me to the star of regret. Come back, Father, where dreaming is real and pain is possible. You will have to believe, and in pain, you will recognize your image at last. Beyond my kingdom of earth, real life marvelous, genuine wonders, dazzling miracles. Look at them. A burning bush, look, a fire wheel, a rum, a rock. Shall I smite it? There, it gushes, and I did it. I am creating this dream now. Will you believe? You. I have your luck, Father, in my dream. And you must remain the final scene. Now, look up high. What do you see? A rainbow which I created for you. My promise, my covenant. Look at it, Father. Believe, believe. Look at my rainbow and say after me. Magnified and sanctified be the great name of man. Of my rainbow are blinding, Father, and they hurt your eyes, I know, but don't close them now. Don't turn away. Look, do you see how simple and peaceful it all becomes once you believe? Thank you.
pain. I will hate to suffer it. The scene, the voices of your children call from corner to corner, chanting your praises. Is chilly.
The dawn is chilly. But the dawn has come. Father, with one another day, we have dreamed our Kaddish and we waken alive. Good morning, Father. We can still be immortal, you and I, bound by our rainbow. That is our covenant, and to honor it is our honor, not quite the covenant we began for so long ago at the time of that other first rainbow, but then I was only your helpless infant, arms hard around you, dead. Without you, we have both grown young and older, you and I. And I'm not sad, and you must not be sad. Unfurrow your brow. Look tenderly again at me, at us, at all these children of God here in this sacred house, and we shall look tenderly back to you. Oh, my Father, Lord of light, beloved, majesty, my image, my self. We are one after all, you and I. Together we suffer, together.